This video is sponsored by Ren.
Some of you may have heard that taller people's hearts have to work harder, or that their lungs are bigger so they have to use more energy to just breathe. You may also have heard that tall people tend to live shorter lives than their shorter counterparts. But if that's true, why? For the most part, in nature, the larger a creature is, the longer it tends to live. Compare the 12-month lifespan of a black rat, one of the smaller animals on Earth, to the 90-year lifespan of a blue whale, the literal largest living creature to ever exist on Earth. And it seems like tall people should be not only growing more than their shorter friends, but also living longer. It's been said that the shorter you are, the closer you are to hell. So could hell be giving short people a longer life? Maybe it should be, the taller you are, the closer you are to the grave. If you want to like this video and leave a comment, you would not believe the difference it makes for us. And please subscribe if you'd like to see more. Thanks! And with that out of the way, let's get into it. So, do tall people lead shorter lives? Do they actually die earlier than shorter people? Well, multiple studies have shown a relationship between increased height and reduced life expectancy. One published in 2017 looked at over 3,000 NBA and ABA basketball players from 1920 to 2017, and found that generally, the shortest players lived the longest, with the average lifespan of 75 years, while the top 5% of tallest players lived the shortest, with an average lifespan of 56 years. Another, looking at the same relationship using military conscripts between 1866 and 1915 from an inland village in Sardinia, Italy, found that shorter recruits lived, on average, 2 years longer than their taller comrades. Men lost around 0.23 years for every extra centimeter of height at 70 years old above the average. That's almost a quarter of a year for just a centimeter. Maybe caffeine-stunting growth is actually a good thing. A third study looked at 373 male veterans from the Veterans Administration in San Diego, who died in between 1984 and 1988. Researchers discovered that men who were under 5'6" lived 4.95 years longer on average than men taller than that. What's more is that men who were shorter than 5'5" lived 7.46 years longer than men taller than 5'9".
Maybe this time will be different.
Future me!
Climate change feels like an insurmountable challenge to overcome. But with today's sponsor, Ren, that challenge is a little more surmountable.
Wait, I thought it was an uprising. You know what? Never mind. How can I help?
Ren.co makes it easy for you to do your part in the fight against the climate crisis. Calculate your carbon footprint by answering a few questions about your lifestyle, and offset it by funding climate initiatives to reduce carbon emissions. If you want to reduce your carbon footprint and help fight for our shared future, you can help out by investing in tree planting operations, mineral weathering, and even rainforest protection. You can sign up for monthly contributions to go toward projects like Mandulas Energy's project, Clean Cooking Fuel for Refugees. Mandulas takes old food waste to turn into fuel and distribute that out to over 1 million refugees in Uganda. You'll even receive updates from the projects you fund, with details on how your money is spent and photos of their progress. Offset your carbon footprint with Ren at ren.co/start/brew. And as a special incentive, the first 100 people who sign up through our link will have 10 extra trees planted in their name.
Wait, other me. How will I know if we've averted the climate crisis?
I will mention that most research across all of the sciences, especially retrospective studies, usually only use men as participants. More recent studies have been looking at this relationship with gender as a factor as well. That being said, the data is very real, if a little skewed. But the question remains, why are taller people dying earlier than their shorter counterparts? Let's take a look at some of the tallest people in history and see what they died of to get an idea of what could be behind this phenomenon. The tallest person ever was a fellow by the name of Robert Wadlow. He was born in 1918 in Illinois, a pretty regular baby. But by age 8, he had already grown past 5 foot 11 inches. Into his adulthood, his stature cracked a whopping 8 foot 11 inches. He passed away at the young age of 22 from a septic blister on his right leg from a botched brace in his leg. Hey, how about Andre the Giant? He was pretty big. Born in 1946, he was diagnosed with acromegaly and grew to 6'6" by the time he was 15. At his death, he was as tall as 7'4" and passed away from congestive heart failure at the age of 46. Their stories don't actually help us much though. Both Andre and Robert had conditions that made them grow so tall. Robert had what's called pituitary gigantism, which, as the name suggests, makes people grow to a gigantic size. Andre, likewise, was diagnosed with acromegaly, which triggers excessive growth. Basically, their conditions affected their health, which excludes them from our data. We're looking at why taller people with no notable health problems tend to die earlier than shorter people. The tallest people in history without growth-related disorders are Angus Macaskill, 7'8", who died at age 37 from brain fever, Manute Bol, 7'7", who died age 47 from Stevens-Johnson syndrome, and Neil Fingleton, 7'7", who died age 36 from heart failure. You may remember Neil from Game of Thrones as Meg the Mighty. In recent news, Igor Vavkovinsky, the tallest living man in the US since 2010, has just passed away August 20th at the age of 38. Standing at a skyscraping 7'8", he spent his last day with his family eating cake and drinking Fanta. You know, I really hope that he had a good day. Anyway, back to the episode. It's hard to do research on subjects like these because people are individuals. They have their own habits, good or bad. They may have genetic illnesses. There are factors at play in an individual's life that makes them bad for a scientific study. So, to get any answers, we need a big sample size. Lucky for us, researchers love large sample sizes because it means they get more accurate data, they can better account for outliers, and their colleagues can't call their work inadequate. Yoon-Jin Choi and other researchers collected data from a national claim survey of over 22 million Korean adults, and in their 5-year follow-up period, just under 800,000 of them were diagnosed with cancer. They found height to be positively associated with cancers in all of these sites, which means that there was a higher ratio of individuals diagnosed with all types of cancer in the tallest portion of the population. But how could height make you more vulnerable to cancer? Well, an article by Dr. Leonard Nunney found out that every 10 centimeters, or 4-ish inches, above an average of 5'3 for women and 5'7 for men, cancer risk increased by a whopping 10%. He argues that one possible explanation could be that taller individuals have a higher cell division rate than shorter people. He notes that this could come from the relationship between a hormone called IGF-1, or insulin-like growth factor, and cancer. This hormone, along with growth hormone, or GH, promote bone and tissue growth. These hormones increase gradually over one's childhood to peak in puberty, then generally drop again once you're an adult. Yet another study found that there is a slight increase in risk of cancer due to higher IGF-1 levels in adulthood. This is corroborated by the fact that individuals with less IGF-1 actually have protection from cancer. So, that's cancer, but what about other illnesses, like heart disease? If you think about it, tall people's hearts have to pump harder to counteract gravity, right? Not to mention that since their bodies are larger, the distance blood needs to move is further. So, maybe tall people have heart problems. It's actually fascinating. As we saw, being tall has been linked to higher risks of developing cancer. But being tall has also been linked to lower risks of cardiovascular disease. Being tall increases cancer risk, but being short increases cardiovascular risk. How wild is that? When researchers identified 180 spots on the human genome that change according to height, they wanted to see which genetic traits also coded for high risks of heart disease. They found that for every 2.5 inches shorter one is from the average, the risk of heart disease increases by 13.5%. The shorter you are, the higher the risk. Another Korean study that observed over 16 million individuals by Dr. Chan Soon Park and others found that, over the course of their 9-year follow-up period, there was a negative relationship between height and heart attacks, heart failure, and strokes, meaning that their taller participants were less often being diagnosed with heart issues than their shorter counterparts. Researchers note that tall stature may be associated with a low mortality from CVD. But that doesn't mean that tall people don't have heart disease, it just means that tall people were dying of other things more often than heart disease. So then, what does this mean? Are tall people actually better off than shorter people? Well, no. Tall people still live shorter lives on average. While tall people may have a lowered risk of heart attack, heart failure, and stroke, they are at an increased risk of atrial fibrillation. AFib is an irregular and rapid heartbeat that can lead to other heart-related conditions. Researchers out of the University of Pennsylvania found that the risk of atrial fibrillation increased about 3% for every 1-inch increase in height over the average. The lead author of the study said that their findings show that a certain group of patients, specifically very tall patients, may benefit from screening for signs of atrial fibrillation. The problem with looking at particular illnesses and their relationship to height is that they can't give you a holistic picture of what's going on. We know that being taller gives you an increased risk of cancer, but we also know that being shorter gives you an increased risk of heart disease. And that doesn't really clear up anything. One theory suggests that a gene group called FOXO might be a factor in determining human longevity. A research article from 2014 by the Honolulu Heart Program made a connection between nutritional balance in childhood, the FOXO genes, and height in adulthood. Basically, the better fed you are as a baby, the taller you will be. Knowing this, researchers found that the FOXO gene was less frequent in taller individuals, which suggested to them that it could be connected to early childhood development. So, one explanation for the fact that tall people generally live shorter lives could be that this FOXO gene is what helps shorter people live longer. Their theory is that one's nutritional intake in infancy determines if it will express itself. Infants who get enough to eat end up growing taller in adulthood. But this special super survival gene doesn't turn on. However, if an infant isn't getting enough food, they'll be a little shorter in adulthood, but this gene will kick in to help them survive. Is FOXO a secret gene that makes us live longer? Maybe, we don't really know yet. Science rarely offers us clear-cut explanations for things. For most of human history, we knew that the sun rose and set, mothers gave birth to children, and the seasons change with the year. But we didn't know why. Like science communicator Destin Sandlin said on his fantastic YouTube show, Smarter Every Day, knowledge is not understanding. We have the knowledge that shorter individuals live longer lives than their taller counterparts, but we don't understand why. It just goes to show that you can have the knowledge of something, but to understand it, you need to dredge up all sorts of complicated, not easily answered questions. But let's be honest. The easiest puzzles are the least satisfying to solve, right?